When we talked about dialogue, what kind of dialogue should it be? It is dialogue which produces no anger or retribution. One of the greatest example of such dialogue was the one between Adi Shankar and Mandan Mishra. It is worth recalling and describing this ancient example for our modern times. Adi Shankar, a Vedantic, who did not give high marks for rituals, was a young man, while Mandan Mishra was an elderly scholar and high ritualist who believed in animal sacrifice also. Adi Shankar wanted to establish through dialogue and debate with the highest authority on ritualism, and that rituals were not necessary for attaining mukti, while Mandan Mishra wanted to prove that Shankar was wrong in dismissing rituals. This was how, in ancient India, debates on sensitive issues between scholars avoided such issues being settled in streets. Adi Shankar and Mandan Mishra held a debate and Shankar won. But the more important point is not the debate itself, but how was the debate conducted. It is a fascinating story that will remain one of the highest forms of debate for all times for humanity. It was agreed that if Mandan Mishra lost, he would cease to be householder, grihastha dharma, and accept sannyas. If Adi Shankar lost, he would give up his sannyas and marry and settle down householder, grihastha life. Mandan Mishra, a high scholar, offered to Adi Shankar, who was young, and therefore Mishra considered unequal to choose a referee of his choice. Adi Shankar chose Mandan Mishra's wife, a scholar herself, as the referee. If Mandan Mishra lost, she would lose her husband. But see what she did. She asked both Shankar and Mandan Mishra to wear fresh garlands and then begin the debate, and said that the one whose garland loses its freshness would be declared as the loser. Why? Because if one gets angry, the body will develop heat, and as a result, the garland flowers will lose their freshness in that heat. Anger within is a sign of defeat. On this logic, Mandan Mishra was declared as having lost the debate, and he accepted sannyas and became disciple of Shankar. This demonstrates the vitality of dialogue, and that too, dialogue without anger and conflict.